Hey YouTube, what's up? It's Tony, and I thought I'd make a view on another web series that I just got done watching. That I promised the writer, producer, and director that I would watch. I watched the first three episodes on Saturday, but I admit that I really didn't pay too much attention to them because it was about time for Saturday Night Live, and I didn't want to miss Saturday Night Live. But anyway, I just got done watching a web series that is two seasons. Hopefully it will go into the third soon. Don't know, when or if these series are going to go into production. It depends on the popularity of them. It also depends on if it gets the word out, also if, depends on funding. Mostly it's funding. Funding has magic effect, making things happen or making things not happen. But anyway, the web series is called Timekeeper. Timekeeper was written, produced, and directed by a good friend of mine named Darren Murphy. I met Darren Murphy through Super Geeked Up, of all places. Lately, I've been meeting a lot of people through Jeff Burns and the Super Geeked Up crew. But yeah, I met, and I use the term met because we haven't met face to face yet. But we met online through tweeting back and forth to each other through the SGU. Times on Wednesday nights when Jeff Burns has his Super Geeked Up webcast. And I got to know Darren a little bit, and we kind of had some banter back and forth about time travel and how it affects video production. I told him probably about 2 or 3 weeks ago that I promised I would watch the whole thing and give a review of it. Surprisingly, since that happened, Saturday I spoke to him and he said that he'd be very willing to do a semi-impromptu interview with me, promoting Timekeeper. And also talking about the work that he's done. But something else happened during that weekend. Sean M. Smith, who I've talked about on a previous episode that I've done, Sean M. Smith, who created King of Fitness, and a friend of his named Brian Thompson, I've talked about Brian a little bit too. They both have started a thing called the Miamiwebfest, which was a festival that was done this weekend, the weekend of, what was it? Saturday was the 5th. So yeah, it was done October 4th, 5th, and 6th, I think. Yeah, that's right. 4th, 5th, and 6th is when the Web Fest happened. I'll put a link up there somewhere, either on the right-hand side or left-hand side to Miami Web Fest, since I've brought it up in this vlog. But pretty much the reason I brought up Miami Web Fest is, like I was saying, it's a festival that celebrates people who make web series, and it was taking place in Miami, Florida, where Brian and Sean live, and was taking place play took place in the Miami-Dade University, and was l streamed live over the Miami-Dade website, in which I watched probably about 70% of the broadcast. I didn't get to see any of Friday's broadcast because I was extremely busy that day. But Saturday, I did get to watch quite a bit of it. Jeff did Super Geeked Up Live there at the at Miamiwebfest, and had a lot of fun watching him and Sean and Darren do Super Geeked Up Live there at the fest. Anyway, the Webfest was streaming on the big movie screen. The different web series that had been submitted for submissions for awards, the win Best in Show, Best in Science Fiction, Best Actress, Best Actor, Best Presentation, that kind of stuff. Typical award ceremony, but it was targeted to web series and web series only. Which, by the way, I did happen to watch on Saturday night the entire ceremony, and it was done very well. Put together very well by Sean and Brian. So anyway, what does Miamiwebfest have to do with Timekeeper Show? With Timekeeper, it just so happened that Darren Murphy won the best sci-fi series at the Miamiwebfest. So yeah, congrats to my friend Darren for winning. It's not an award you can win or wear. It's when you won. But he won the very first award for best science fiction web series. And the reason I say it's very first is because this is the very first annual Miamiwebfest. And I wish them luck in the future, and I hope that they do this next year and the year after and many years to come. I've already told them that on both Twitter and my Facebook page, that Miamiwebfest is a great thing that needs to be done in the future to get the web series industry noticed. So anyway, back to the review of Timekeeper. Like I said, Darren Murphy, he had won the best sci-fi best sci-fi award at the Miamiwebfest, and that's a great accomplishment. So, on to my review of Timekeeper. Timekeeper had 10 episodes in the second series and 6 episodes in the first series. I started watching the first series. Like I said, I started watching on Saturday, and I was kind of just had it on for background noise, to be honest with you. But I really started watching it, and as I got deeper into the series, it was a wild, fascinating ride that kind of made you question about time and what time was anyway. It was kind of like a cross between Quantum Leap and Sliders meeting hit Groundhog Day. Quantum Leap and Sliders meeting Groundhog Day. That's the best way that I could put it. And then also there was some other little things hinted in there too, like Star Trek and Time Tunnel and pretty much anything to do with science fiction or time travel in general, it was put in there. To give you an idea about what the show is about, I'm reading here on, I'll show you. There's my laptop right there. It's hard for me to give a review on this show other than saying that it was a weird, wild ride where Quantum Leap and Sliders meet Groundhog Day. But it was also in this series, it made me really question about who some of these characters were, what the role was as far as good guys or bad guys. Sometimes it took some very dramatic plot twists. You're like, okay, wait a minute, I thought that was a good guy, but no, wait a minute, okay, now he's acting good again. What's the deal with this? But I'm going to review, or not with the whole thing, but I'm going to review to of Timekeeper from the Snobby Robot site. Snobby Robot, of course, I've talked about Snobby Robot before. I've talked about it on a semi-impromptu interview, the one I did with my friend Chris Hadley, who happens to be a writer. He's a writer for this. He did not write this review, but I knew, hey, if I want to get a good review of this, better than what I could give, because I'm just like, it would come from Snobby Robot. Snobby Robot pretty much just says, and I quote, and I will put a link to Snobby Robot's review in an annotation up here. I will also put a link to Darren Murphy's channel, where you can go and look at both seasons of Timekeeper. And he is also has another series out that he's just working on that is along the same lines of time travel, where this future version of himself comes and annoys the ever-living beep of his past self, which is what I've gotten from the little bit I've seen of Darren's new show. You can also find a link to that. You can find a link to the one or two episodes he's done of that. But anyway, Snobby Robot says, Timekeeper is a sci-fi series in the vein of Quantum Leap. The show follows Mitch, which actually his whole name was Mitch Mathers. The show follows Mitch, a man stuck in a messed up time, a loop thing. Essentially, Mitch awakens in a certain time and place unknown to him, with all knowledge of his previous experience wiped clean. All he has is the vision of the future that he has to make happen to move on and seemingly right some potential future wrong. He goes on saying that the show fits right into classic television, sci-fi television in a ball. Quantum Leap is the most obvious comparison. The show has its moments, called under mind, like Doctor Who, Slider, Terminator, and among others. Of course, I named some others, like, I didn't even think of Doctor Who when I was watching this, but, yeah, I can see where it comes from. Sliders, yeah, I can see where it comes from, too. To me, it kind of just seemed like it was more like a Quantum Leap kind of thing. And, also Sliders, too. But I couldn't help but thinking the weird movie with Bill Murray. It was, like that. Anyway, I really hope you enjoy this review. And, I'll talk to you later. Bye.